Hi, my name's Sean from Email Experts. We help e-commerce brands grow through email and automated marketing. In this video, I'll go over how you can nurture your new visitors and convert them to become first-time customers through a welcome series. I'll first show you how to set it up technically, and then the strategy that we recommend to maximize sales through the welcome series. So here's the basic funnel. When someone signs up to your website, they're presented with a pop-up prompting them to join the mailing list. We went through setting up a pop-up in a previous video, so check that out. Once they sign up, the welcome series is triggered, and if it goes to plan, they'll make a purchase. Okay, so first the technical component. So in Klaviyo, you will need to find the list that you will use to trigger your welcome series. In this example, I'll be using the newsletter list. Now I go to flows. So I'll go to flows, click create flow in the top right corner, search for welcome, and click welcome series standard, just the basic welcome series. Choose the list that you want to use to trigger and click create flow. Now choose how many emails you want to have and the timing. The easiest way to do this is just to click on these little dots and click clone. And we recommend using 6 emails. And you can clone the timing as well. And we recommend having 6 emails and space them one day apart. So with the Klaviyo editor here, you can click on any component and just configure it on the left panel. So this is how I'll do it for the days. And you can just drag and drop the different components within the builder. So you want to space it to be 6 apart and then turn these so that they're one day apart. So here's one that I've prepared that is set up in the way that I want it to be prepared. I'll just zoom out a little bit to get a bit of a sense of the whole thing. Then I'll zoom back in. So we've got 6 emails here, all one day apart. So now I'll run through each of the rules. First, as I mentioned, it's triggered when someone subscribes to newsletter. Then each customer runs through the series through each email with a day delay. Now, because the purpose of the welcome series is to encourage customers to make their first purchase, I recommend adding a rule so that when customers make a purchase, they stop receiving the welcome series. The way to do that is you click on this trigger at the top here. Click over here to flow filters. Click add a flow filter. Click a condition. When someone has done or not done something, go to placed order. Now, this will be whichever e-commerce platform you're using. Click 0 times since starting this flow. And the way that this works is that when someone goes through the flow, at each email point of the flow, Klaviyo will check back with this flow filter to make sure that it's still true. So for example, if someone receives welcome email 1 and then welcome email 2 and then makes an order, then by the time they get to welcome email 3, it will check to see if they've placed an order 0 times since starting the flow. They will only receive this email if they've placed an order 0 times since starting this flow. So we click save. Sometimes we see people adding a conditional split after each of the emails for customers who have placed an order or something like that. That's unnecessary when you add the flow filter at the top. So I'll just click delete that conditional split. Finally, on the first email and the last email, I recommend turning off smart sending. So smart sending is the feature within Klaviyo. So just click on the box and click smart sending, toggle that. That's the feature that makes sure that customers don't receive too many emails at once. So if they've received an email earlier in the day, then they won't receive an email that has smart sending turned on. We want to make sure that customers don't miss out on the first and last email. So I recommend turning off smart sending for those emails. Great, so that's it. Technically, it's pretty straightforward. You set up your pop-up, as we mentioned in the previous video. So customers will flow through each message, hopefully converting them to subscribers. To configure each message, click on the box, click edit, and that will take you to the Klaviyo editor. Again, we made a video that runs through how to build a great email design. The link to both videos is below. So you're probably wondering what the content of these emails should look like. So as I mentioned, there should be 6 emails, all spaced one apart. And this is just reflective of what we just showed in Klaviyo. Remember, the goal of the welcome series is to convert would-be window shoppers into paying customers. To do this, you need to overcome the barriers a customer has in making a purchase. There are 2 common barriers all e-commerce businesses face: shipping cost and trust. In addition to other barriers that might be specific to your product or brand. For example, you may be required to educate your customer about your product, how to use it, and its benefits. or if you have an expensive product, then overcoming price concerns. Each email should have a single message and call to action. If you add an additional message and make your email longer, then make sure the call to action at the top of the email is really clear. So here's the strategy for the first six emails. The first, second, and last emails should be focused on the offer. Customers signed up for it in the first place. Emails 3, 4, and 5 are about systematically overcoming the barriers around shipping, trust, education, and other barriers, using social proof of bestsellers and reviews, and directly addressing the most common concerns in an FAQ-style email. So I'll just run through each of them now. So, for welcome one, just as I said, just deliver the offer. It's about fulfilling the promise that you made in the pop-up about sending them the offer that they signed up for in the first place. So keep the message simple, have a really simple email design, just with a hero section, heading, copy, call to action, and in that copy section, include the discount code. If you want to use a dynamic discount code with Shopify, then check out our video on that. So then each customer receives a unique coupon code. So here's an example of that, where Frank Body just has a really simple hero image, text, the button, and the coupon code. And I'm going to go back to Frank Body because you don't want to vary too much in each of the emails in the discount emails. So again, for welcome to, it's just the discount reminder. Again, I've just used Frank Body here as the example because you don't want to vary the message too much. You just want to remind them that they signed up in the first place and that you've got an offer for them. So email 3, share the range. Talk about bestsellers. I recommend using the term bestsellers because it appeals to the social proof. So here's an example from Kester Black of bestsellers, the most popular sellers. And you can populate this within Klaviyo using a product recommendation grid, which will make sure that customers are only seeing products that are still in stock. Welcome 4, the main concern here is addressing common FAQs and again, overcoming the barriers that customers may have. So choose your FAQs around questions that customers often have that are specific to your brand, but also address common concerns. So like I said, the common concerns are shipping, trust, and then other things specific to your product. So especially around education, if your product is complicated or expensive. So here's an example. And then from a customer experience perspective, I recommend keeping the FAQs short and then putting a call to action that links to the FAQ section on your website. Getting customers to the website will be the most important aspect of this to get them browsing again. Welcome 5, social proof. Again, overcoming these common barriers that customers have. And don't just show any reviews. I don't recommend populating them from a feed from Yotpo. I recommend choosing the reviews specifically to overcome barriers around shipping and trust. So showcase reviews from customers that have talked about the product arriving safely, the product arriving well, in good quality. And so focus strategically on choosing reviews that address those concerns that other customers have. So here's an example here of a simple layout that allows you to showcase multiple reviews. And finally, final offer reminder. Deliver the offer again, use urgency, and perhaps even use a countdown timer. And here's an example of a brand that's done that. Really simple design, making it really straightforward to encourage customers to go back to the website. And the countdown timer, using a platform like Nifty Images, will allow you to inject a sense of urgency into this email design, which will hopefully by this stage, all of the barriers have been overcome and you'll get good conversions on this email. And that's it. With this welcome series, combined with our other video on adding a pop-up to your website, you should be able to convert website visitors to become email subscribers and email subscribers to become first-time customers. This video is part of a series on setting up your core Klaviyo flows. Check out our other videos we've recorded on the pop-up and abandoned cart flows. Please like and subscribe and leave a comment below on any other email marketing topics you'd like me to cover. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.